Which animal did Richard I have three of on his shirt?
Now, can I suggest that at this point in history, no one in England had ever seen a lion. Is that possible? So, it's not a lion.
What did Richard I spend most of his time doing?
I don't know.
Crusading.
There weren't any lions in Arabia, were there?
There were lions all over Africa.
They're bloody everywhere they were.
So he saw a lion.
Zoos. The Tower of London had a menagerie. It was a little later, I grant you.
You had a picnic in those days. Not wasps.
Lions. Millions of
them. Get off the sandwich!
What? Point is...
Decent lions!
Swans are the bastards.
It's... He looks like... You know what he looks like? He looks like he's going, "Ooh, get you in your suit of armour." He looks like he's doing a sort of, "Ooh."
This is the badge of English royalty that was first used by Richard I. And it's three...
Well, I'm saying not lions.
You're right to avoid the word lions. Track. They were known as leopards. They called them leopards. They were not particularly familiar with the difference between a leopard and a lion. A leopard really just means a bearded lion, leopard. And it's a heraldic thing. If they were in that shape, sideways on, those were leopards. You know, so, there was a song, wasn't there?
There was a song.
Wasn't there, Frank Skinner?
And that would have caused me a lot of scanning problems.
Yes, it would, wouldn't it? It was based, however, on a lie. Three lions on my shirt.
It was based on a lion.
Three leopards on my shirt.
Were they rampant or couchant?
Good question.
It's got a good sign of the century.
Yes. They were actually passant gardant. But the rampant lion is the sign of the kings of Scotland.
Very hairy knees, the Scottish ones.
Yes, they have. They would be called lions in heraldry, whereas the three lions on the shirt would in fact be known as leopards.